Hi there, I'm Brianna Keeler in for Kate Baldwin. President Trump calling for unity in his State of the Union address and declaring that we're living in a new American moment. Morning, we learned that the special counsel wants to interview a former spokesman for the president's legal team, and he wants to know more about Jeff Sessions' offer to resign as attorney general. CNN for joining me. So, Sean, I wonder what you make of this conversation that was had with Chris Wray and with Rod Rosenstein, who is the DOJ official in charge of overseeing. Think it's met that threshold. Is that your impression?
They don't think it's met that threshold.
Mentioned this, Margaret, that the president made that comment last night 100% when talking about releasing the Nunes memo before having read it. I mean, the White House is sort of, at least it appears, and perhaps it was Kabuki theater, said, you know, they're going about the right channels, they're doing this the right way, and yet the president hadn't read that when he said that.
No, and the way the agency operated and the way that investigation is operated.
Backing up what Democrats on the Intel committee who have read the memo are alleging.
No one's going to accuse Chris Wray of being a Democrat.
And the White House, Margaret, what do they want out of this?
Well, to some extent, they've already gotten what they wanted out of it, which is...
Michael, I'm going to be talking to a House Intel committee member here in just a moment, Mike Quigley. And he apparently asked Nunes what has become a key question. Did the White House have involvement in the drafting of this memo? This was in a committee meeting. He's saying that the answer was unclear, that Nunes did not answer negatively, did not say, no, the White House didn't have involvement in this. What would it mean if the White House were involved in the drafting of this memo?
So
take the Trump transition official and then this that you're about to tell
us. And then he went to the White House. Is about the Steele dossier and... In the same way that they drafted the...
Clearly, one thing that needs to be said is this, under no circumstance would the FISA court ever grant a warrant based solely on information and...
Some of the dossier is not corroborated, Margaret. Some of it is. I mean, especially the overarching claims in the dossier.
There are, of course, some...
Court because they're not confirmed.
The lightning rod of this, but their own FBI. In.
Margaret, thank you so much. Michael, really appreciate it. Sean, so glad to have you with us. And coming up, did Devin Nunes coordinate with of this crash of a train carrying Republican members of Congress? It crashed into this garbage truck. And at this point in time, it seems like serious injuries, at least for the two people, it appears two people who were in that garbage truck and according to the congressman you just heard, thrown from that truck. We have a whole lot more on this. Inside Politics with Dana Bash starts right now. She'll pick up our special coverage. Happening now, breaking news. Wolf Blitzer is off. I'm Brianna Keeler. You're in the Situation Room. News, we are tracking major new developments that may weigh heavily in the special counsel's Russia investigation, raising new questions about a possible obstruction with the FBI director. Why is this so significant? Because it's pretty eye-popping.
It's significant because this memo is fundamentally inaccurate. Last week, you had the Department of Justice and to the GOP leadership, frankly, which backs releasing this memo. This is wrong. It's inaccurate.
Point on this. Look, obviously, if we don't know, we haven't seen the memo, we don't know the facts of this, but this has happened. Nunes has done this in a very Republican way. With Schiff and the Democrats not involved.
I want to get to
We have seen this show before, right, with Devin Nunes, yeah. With the allegations about unmasking during that process.
He was cleared.
I do want to get to a CNN exclusive because this is some breaking news we have. I want to bring in Evan Perez and Pamela Brown to talk about this. It seems like there has been another request for loyalty from the president, Evan.
Well,
it seems a little deja vu, Pamela, because we've heard about former FBI Director James Comey when he testified that President Trump had asked him for, thought this was the same thing.
Well, we're told by sources familiar with this meeting, Brianna, that Rosenstein appeared surprised by the president's questions in the Oval Office. He didn't provide any details of the direction of the Russia investigation, and he responded awkwardly to the president's team request, saying, quote, of course, Mr. President, I'm on your team, we're all on your team. Now, at the December hearing, shortly after that White House meeting, Rosenstein was asked about loyalty pledges, and here's what he said.
And Evan, this reporting of yours shows that the president seemed particularly focused on that December
hearing. To ask of Rosenstein were ever actually asked in the hearing.
Jake, we know that loyalty is so important to this president,
yeah.
But there's a difference between loyalty being important, which I think we've seen with other politicians, and asking for a pledge of loyalty. It seems to be something that we're seeing over and over.
Yeah, well, I would argue that in terms of the specifics of what he's saying, although it's certainly all of a piece of he really values loyalty, he wants to know again. It seems to suggest quite the opposite, in fact.
And if you're looking, Jim, at an investigation into obstruction of justice, would this meet the standard for a data point in that, or is this just inappropriate?
I defer to the lawyers, but for loyalty, firing of, say, your FBI director, but intent is key.
It's between the Justice Department and the White House, but clearly the president takes it personally when he to relay the displeasure that the president had. Clearly, to him, he views it as, you know, that.
By the way, I think everybody at the Justice Department is wondering whether or not, when is the day that the president...
A Democratic president doing this, Attorney General, but there's supposed to be an independence when it comes to investigations.
And remember the reaction to the Loretta Lynch, Bill Clinton tarmac meeting, right, during the midst of that investigation.
Which was a former president. Entirely...
Double standard,
which
perhaps
was entirely fishy.
Jake, Jim, Evan, Pamela, thank you so much to all of you. Next, we do have more breaking news right now, a CNN exclusive. And you've also learned that they were not sure that Comey should have gone public.
Yeah, that's letters.
So interesting, Jim Sciutto, because the text messages were key to Republicans as they argued that this is bias. This is bias against Donald Trump. But then you look at what Monty just reported, and it just really defeats that narrative.
Well, you've had a lot of legs under greater scrutiny. I mean, remember, there was all this talk about the secret society last week, again, based on a town this president during the campaign. When you look at it, it's clearly a more complicated picture about the role that he played here.
It's repeated so many times, it sticks. And it has been all of this messaging on the text messages showing bias from Strzok and extrapolating that that's bias on the part of the larger investigation. It's been going on for some time. So even when you learn something new that runs completely counter to that, what effect does it have when the waters have already been muddy?
It matter. You don't want FBI agents or prosecutors sending texts like and Largetta reporting complicates the image, because if he's encouraging the FBI director at the time about releasing that publicly. So we don't know what the reason for that.
Just remember, there's the inspector general.
Mueller took them seriously enough that he did remove them from the investigation.
All right, Manu, thank you so much. Jim Sciutto and Jake Tapper, thank you so much for joining us. And coming up, we have more on the political happening now. We want to welcome our viewers in the United States and around the world. Wolf Blitzer is off today. I'm Brianna Keeler. You're in The Situation. That report now to a CNN exclusive on the president appearing to question the loyalty of another top official overseeing the Russia investigation. It happened first to FBI Director James Comey before he was fired. And now we're learning that the current Deputy Attorney General, Rod Rosenstein, faced similar questions from President Trump just last month. And we're joined now by your reporting shows the president was particularly focused on that December hearing.
That's right. A source familiar with the matter tells me that he was very focused. In fact, Brianna, he brought a hearing. Brianna.
Interesting. Pamela Brown, Laura Jarrett, great exclusive reporting. Thank you so much for that report. Now, tonight, we clearly have many questions, some new questions for the White House about the president's conversations with his deputy attorney general, as well as the stunning public pushback that he's getting from his handpicked FBI director. So we're following a lot of breaking news this hour, including a stunning show of defiance by the president's FBI director. We're joined now by our reporters and analysts to talk about this. And I want to start with you, Gloria Borger. You know, looking at having covered Washington for some time, how incredible is it to see the FBI and the president of the United States at odds like this?
It's just stunning. 100%. I'm going to release this. So the president now fired? I mean, we don't know the answers to these questions.
Jeffrey Toobin, he is the president's handpicked FBI director. You've had some Republicans alleging that there is this deep state of Obama administration holdovers, that they are anti-Trump. Well, this is not one of those. This is someone that President Trump picked who's trying to stop the release of the memo. What does that tell you?
Well, it tells you that the Republicans in Congress are getting most of their information from tinfoil hats. I mean, that has been a conservative law enforcement institution. That's what the FBI was. That's what
it's before, as Jeffrey said. And you know a thing or two about the FBI. What are folks there saying about this conflict that spilled out so publicly?
So I think today's a proud moment for some of them, because
a little battered without being able to say.
Yeah, and look at the headlines that this statement has made. And there is a feeling really that he's doing this for the White House, that he's doing this for police.
To be clear on that, he did remove himself. He was facing an ethics inquiry. He was cleared of that. And clearly he's injected himself back into this.
But that raises another question, Gloria. I mean, where is the speaker asserting control in this situation?
You hear the speaker saying in a way, he's trying to make a distinction, which I wonder if it's lost on some people, but he's just trying to say, you know, when you're dealing with all of this memo stuff, keep it separate from the Russia investigation. I mean, the cat's out of the bag.
Well, the president isn't doing that. The president knows that this is very much aligned with the Russia investigation.
Right. Sabrina, we have some exclusive reporting. The president asked the Deputy Attorney General, Rod Rosenstein, where this was back. Be clear, that's just last month, right? So this is after there have been many times where the president is aware, hey, you don't do this kind of thing, but he asks him, you know, where's the investigation headed? He asks if he's on his team. Mm-hmm. This is the kind of thing that we go, oh my gosh, you know, explain why that's so
And this
out
there. Is not just the nation's top law enforcement agency is there to serve him.
He knows, right? Because he's been told over and over, but maybe it seems, Sabrina, like he doesn't, he's just disregarding
that. And he is fixated on
Bill Clinton was impeached for obstruction of justice. And, you know, how many times do we have to see this from There's a difference between going to the Secretary of the Treasury and say, you know, I want you to be loyal to my tax proposal. I want you to be on the team.
Shimon,
law enforcement is different.
In terms of the obstruction investigation today, this would probably be something that Rod would know.
You know, and a lack of knowledge about this doesn't mean that you can't also obstruct justice.
Thank you so much to all of you. Five of my favorite people here with me this evening. I appreciate it. And still ahead. New tonight, CNN has learned that a test of U.S. missile defenses against North Korea failed. It's a potentially troubling setback as Kim Jong-un's regime threatens to attack the United States. We're also learning more this hour about the mysterious murder of Kim's half-brother, and our Brian Todd has been digging into that. What are you learning, Brian?
Brianna, we have
Brianna Keeler, thank you so much for watching. Aaron Burnett out front starts right now.